Before the Duterte administration, alam ko yan, dalawang tao yan. I think nasa Cebu pa ata. Oh, hindi siya, wala nga sila sa Mindanao, nasa Cebu lang yata sila. Pagdating ng Duterte administration, headline yan eh. Headline project yan eh. Mindanao Railway. Flagship project yan eh. And then after the Duterte administration, tatlong tao na lang. Ano pa? So, how come ganyan tayo mag-decide parang naligo lang tayo, naisipan natin paglabas natin sa shower, sabihan natin, oh, gawa tayo ng railway, tapos naligo naman yung new leader, paglabas niya, sabihin niya, hindi, ayaw na natin. Ganun? Is that how we decide? Teka, tama po ba yung facts ko? Teka, si Secretary naman, you have people there with institutional memory. Tama ba yung facts ko? Yung Project Management Office ng Mindanao Railway, before Duterte administration, dalawang tao. Tama? Ngayon, tatlong tao. Facts yan. In between, during the Duterte administration, lumaki yan. Of course, din naging flagship project yan eh. And then, it's that easily abandoned.
Your Honor, Mr. President, because as you are correct, no, that during the Duterte administration, it was tama kayo na announce na talaga Mindanao Railway project will be a flagship project, no, of yung flagship project nila ng Duterte administration, yung kanyang infrastructure.
Bagong Dudigos naman.
That's the face. Yes. First face your other, Mr. President.
Before the Duterte administration, yung Project Management Office sa dalawang tao, ano yun? Iligan to Cagayan de Oro yun. Ang focus nun. Oh.
Yes, Your Honor. But fortunately, when at the onset of the new administration, we withdrew the loan application because hindi po nagkasundo with the Exim Bank ba, no? DOF and China Exim Bank had a disagreement, so we withdrew the loan application. So probably one of the reasons that the DBM did not put funding anymore, kasi nga po hindi na po siya ongoing. But ang sa DOTR naman po kasi there's a policy difference sa kanila po kasi they would want to continue funding it because there yung mga prerequisites po that were discussed earlier, no, yung pong land acquisition, utilities, relocation has to continue, so that for example the Mindanao Railway project is an EDA approved project, this will happen later on, but we're hoping that the DOTR is hoping that the Mindanao Railway project will still be funded para po yung mga prerequisites will be taken care of so that when the project commences in the future, at least po hindi na maulit yung mga same mistakes that we are encountering now with the NSCR and the Metro Manila Subway project.
Okay, so the Mindanao Railway project is still part of the rail transport program.
And yes, Your Honor.
And then when you planned your budget, what is the amount that you gave to the project? So Mindanao Railway project under a program siya. So magkano po?
Your Honor, Mr. President, the DOTR is requesting 5.4 billion, Your Honor. So 5.4 billion po yung Mindanao Railway project.
Okay. And that is found if we now examine the committee report, that's in the programmed.
Zero po siya lahat. It's not in the NEP, it's not in the GAP. So it's zero, Your Honor, Mr. President.
Ah, so
what they requested?
Nasa budget request nyo. Okay, wala sa NEP. Okay. Apo. So kaya lang, kunyari, okay. So that we will understand. Therefore, what does that mean, Secretary? That if an administration gives it a zero budget, is the project abandoned? Not necessarily.
It's on hold, Your Honor, Mr. President.
On hold, okay.
Because it's the NEDA approved project, so.
But definitely we have incurred expenses pursuant to that project. So pwede nating yung mga ganyan, yung mga projects on hold, siguro si Senator Joel Villanueva will have to also track the expenses for projects on hold. Idagdag yun sa commitment fees. Oh, sige, can we have an example? Example na lang natin. Yung Mindanao Railway Project, how much have we spent for it so far? Okay, kahit yung Tagum to Digos lang, yung portion na yun. Example lang, para malaman ng ating mga kababayan. Example lang natin. Yung Mindanao Railway Project, how much have we spent for it so far? Okay, kahit yung Tagum to Digos lang, yung portion na yun. Example lang, para malaman ng ating mga kababayan.
While they are looking for the total figures, Your Honor, yung pong Mindanao Railway System project, yung pong phase 1, yung pong Tagum to Digos, they have already spent some funds already for the right-of-way acquisition, acquisition of land.
Yes.
They have downloaded some funds to the LGUs, no? For the land acquisition, right? Also yung relocation among others, no? So ang problema ho ngayon because of the sa 2024 hindi na ho nilagyan, tatlo na lang po yung pong personnel in Mindanao Railway. Yung monitoring will be a challenge.
Yes. That's why in example lang po natin now how wasteful we are with our money, but this is hindi naman ito yung umpisahan sa time ni Secretary, but pinapakita lang po natin yung pursuant to that project. So pwede nating yung mga ganyan, yung mga projects on hold, siguro si Senator Joel Villanueva will have to also track the expenses for projects on hold. Idagdag yun sa commitment fees. Oh, sige, can we have an example? Example na lang natin. Yung Mindanao Railway Project, how much have we spent for it so far? Okay, kahit yung Tagum to Digos lang, yung portion na yun. Example lang para malaman ng ating mga kababayan.
While they are looking for the total figures, Your Honor, yung pong Mindanao Railway System project, yung pong phase 1, yung pong Tagum to Digos, they have already spent some funds already for the right-of-way acquisition, acquisition of land.
Yes.
They have downloaded some funds to the LGUs, no? For the land acquisition, right? Also yung relocation among others, no? So ang problema ho ngayon because of the sa 2024 hindi na ho nilagyan, tatlo na lang po yung pong personnel in Mindanao Railway. Yung monitoring will be a challenge.
Yes. That's why in example lang po natin now how wasteful we are with our money, but this is hindi naman ito yung umpisahan sa time ni Secretary, but pinapakita lang po natin yung sistema natin sa gobyerno, kasi pera naman ng taong bayan yan, eh. Oh, so ilan po yun, magkano po yun, sample lang, example applyan natin.
Your Honor, according to DOTR, they have spent about 5.5 billion downloaded to LGUs for land acquisition for the right of way of tag. Ito yung first phase pa lang.
Yes,
Tagum to Digos.
Eh, tama naman yun. Tama naman. Mabuti nga. You're being very open and transparent about it. Eh, siyempre, 5.5 billion pesos na for a project na tawagin na lang natin, let's use your technical terminology, on hold. May we know how many... Yes?
Check something.
Yes. Wala kang mic, sir.
Yes, if you say on hold, ibig sabihin yung project is on hold, depende sa availability ng funds, am I correct? The project will be put on hold until the availability of funds, am I correct?
That's correct, Mr. President, that according to the OTR, additional preparatory works, no, prior to the loan agreement, if ever it pushes through, are not being done because of the lack of funding. In this case, for 2025, Your Honor, Mr. President, yung kanila pong 5.4 billion, yung sa NEPO is zero. So talagang on hold po ito.
So paano yan kung wala nang mga funds na darating? So ano magiging ano nung structure niyan, magiging white elephant? Kung wala nang halimbawa ng pondo dumating, what will happen to the structure that has been started?
Your Honor, Mr. President, that is why one of the reasons that the DOTR is appealing for funds so that the project management office, for example, of the Mindanao Railway System, would continue. Kasi po, sa ngayon, if I may give it the figures, yung pong 2021 right of way ang na-release po for Mindanao Railway is 325.7 million or anong 2020 545.6 million that will be used to acquire land that will be used for the right of way of the Mindanao Railway. Ito po yung Tagum to Digos.
So may I know what projects are still on hold, if I may? How many projects are still on hold?
And
with the intelligence of the minority leader.
That was my next question.
Your Honor, mostly the railway projects. No? Ito pong Mindanao Railway System, and we can already also consider South Long Haul. Although may funding siya ng konti noong 2024, kung hindi rin po mapupondo ito, it will be on hold also. Ito yung South Long Haul, ito po yung Bicol Line, no, from Metro Manila going to
Bicol. So how many projects all in all, Mr. Sponsor?
Total
na. Priority na priority.
Apat po, Your Honor, Mr. President. Sa tatlong railway, Mindanao Railway, South Long Haul, ito po yung Bicol, and MRT4, ito po yung MRT going to Rizal, no? Ito po yung papuntan Rizal, Taytay Rizal, and isama na rin po yung New Dumaguete Airport project, no, which received zero allocation.
Are these foreign funded projects?
Yes, Your Honor, Mr. President.
So kung hindi nagbigay ang hinihintay natin pondo galing sa labas, so the project will not push through.
Your Honor, Mr. President, ito po yung magiging consequences, no, if actual requirements will not be given to these aforementioned projects, no. Delay on project preparation, such as procurement of ito pong yung right of way, yung pong land acquisition, yung pong relocation, yung pong pag-ano sa contractor, no, yung engagement of the contractor, and start of construction itself. So all of this will experience delays, Your Honor, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Sponsor. Minority Leader.
Thank you, Mr. President. Yun yung next question kung mabuti. At saka thank you for being really anong tawag mo doon, upfront with us, DOTR. At least apat, na we can say that not less than four major projects are infra projects are on hold. Okay.
Yes, that is correct.
Okay,
three railway and one airport, Your Honor.
Light railway, yung MRT.
MRT4 yung po metro, going to Rizal. Rizal line po ito.
Rizal line. Which is unfortunate kasi to quote the President, I think President Marcos announced a Railway Renaissance. Tama ba, Secretary? Do you confirm that? Did he say that? Minapa-double check ko that. Did he say it?
Yes, Your Honor. That's correct.
There will be a Railway Renaissance. Sabi ba ng boss niyo, sir? Principal niyo. Oh. And then three railway projects are on hold. So how do we reconcile words with the reality?
To add to that, Your Honor, Mr. President, most of the railway projects funding were substantially reduced, no, from the NEP to the GAB. Na bawasan pa.
Paano ba yan, Mr. Secretary? Paano yun? Nagiging executive na yung nagiging executive ang legislature? Kasi dapat ba sa the budget begins with the executive branch, and you know our cash in, cash out. You also contract the loans. Kayo mismo yan eh. And then you set the priority infrastructure, and yet Congress halves your budget. disables you. Wala.
Pero again, according to DOTR Secretary Jimmy, they were surprised, no, last year's BICAM, na talagang nalipat ng karamihan ng mga foreign assistance programs, pushed down from program to unprogram. And that's why, Your Honor, Mr. President, from my opening statement, being the sponsor and advocacy natin po itong infrastructure, I would want to propose an amendment at the proper time to retain funding of the priority projects in the program funds, Your Honor, Mr. President.
Sige po, siguro kailangan medyo firm din ang Senate panel pagdating sa BICAM. Diba? If we believe in something, let's also stand by it siguro sa BICAM.
Yes, Your Honor, we'll do our best, no? And as you say, tama rin, I agree with the minority leader, talagang dapat pag-priority programs, foreign assisted, dapat talaga nandun sa line yun, nandun sa program. Kasi well, nilagay mo saan program, that is dependent on the revenues, no, that will be raised by government. So hindi siya priority kung nilagay mo sa program.
Saka kasi when we say, I think we also... Sa Duterte administration, the president, then President Duterte, used the phrase golden age of infrastructure. I do not know now, hindi yata ginagamit ni President Marcos yun, but pagdating sa targeted 5-6% infra expenditure of 5-6% of GDP, parang ganun. I think that has been retained. So parang kahit hindi ginagamit yung phrase na golden age of infrastructure, in effect, golden age of infrastructure pa rin ang target ninyo. But when we say golden age of infrastructure, gusto natin makita, not only, actually, hindi siguro yung more roads, but yung mga ganito, railway, airports, seaports, ganun, yun, that's the golden age of infrastructure.
That's correct, Your Honor, Mr. President. Maka yung golden age of infrastructure of the previous administration targeted up to increase spending. Yeah. From 5 to 6%. Actually, the previous year, nasa 2% na nga lang, kaya tayo siguro napag-iwanan. So, at least the last administration, it went up to 5 to 6%. Yung pong golden age of infrastructure, yung pong build program. Ito pong pagpasok ng Marcos administration, they wanted to improve or even surpass to the build better more.
Correct.
Yes. Kaya lang, dito nga, I agree with you. I share the same frustration. Why, how come, question pa rin natin, priority projects are relegated to the program.
Appropriate. No, I don't necessarily agree. Pero gusto ko sabihin, I'm just pointing it out. Yeah? Yan ang sinasabi ng administration. So, ayun ko, sino ba nag-pledge to help the administration? The department is pledged to help the administration. I do not know which group in the Senate is pledged to help the administration, which group in the House is pledged to help the administration. Kami, taga-apo na. Kami po, taga-apo na. Taka-test ng ideas ninyo.
That, test we really appreciate your honor, Mr. President. Sige, mabuti po. Lagi niyo pinupuna para maitulak ko natin. We're hoping.
Tingnan natin kung nagmamatch ang aksyon sa salita. Ano naman eh. Pero kung hindi, that's not our problem. We just point it out. Okay, so kaya nga sana yung mga attach agencies dito sa DOTR, yung mga offices na internal to the DOTR, huwag nyo nabigyan ng additional sakit ng ulo si Secretary. Ang dami ng problema. Ganun? I mean, di ba? Huwag natin nabigdagdagan ng problema ni Secretary kasi ang hirap eh, itong ano budget ninyo. It's really like a you know, walang ano, there's no predictability, there is no formula, there is no stability. Hindi mo maintindihan. So parang,
Your Honor,
kung saan ang iyak na hangin. I mean, and we're talking about big ticket infrastructure projects of the Republic of the Philippines papunta lang sa ihip ng hangin.
Parang ang roller coaster, pero ang gusto
but
natin...
But I think sa interpellation kanina yata ni Senator Risa, the chairman mentioned your bill, pero sana nga, yun lang yung point ko, how can that really put some stability? So yun ang ating pag-aralan.
With the permission of the minority leader, may I know what is the flagship project of the DOTR? If there is any...
Your Honor, Mr. President, it's still the same. No, it's mostly the railway projects, the North-South Commuter Line, the Metro Manila subway system.
Is that put on hold in yung flagship project?
Ay, di po. Itong dalawa, full blast na po ito. No? In right. fact, the NSCR, pag dumalo kayo ng SCTX, you can see already the columns nandun na po, umaabot na po sa Clark.
What are the other flagship projects that are being put on hold?
The four projects, no,
that you mentioned,
railway, that, that were mentioned earlier, Honor. All right.
Thank you.
Kasi Japan.
Minority Leader.
Sige po, ganun na lang. Hindi ko na lang isa-isahin itong mga...
This will be an ODA, Your Honor, with the French government, Your Honor, Mr. President.
So okay, so thank you to the government of France for helping us. Pero hindi naman to grant, so it's really a borrowing, also a loan, no. Pero siguro yung ano concessionary rates and terms.
Yes, Your Honor, it's a 15-year loan from ODA po na Overseas Development Assistance from the Sige. French government for 40 vessels.
Thank you. I'll just raise two other personal interest matters. So, itong we can observe the increasing usage of drones. Do drones pose a danger to aviation? Kasi iba-iba yata ang sizes niyan, even the small ones. Do they pose a danger to aviation?
Your Honor, based on KAAP, yes, it will really pose a danger. No? Kasi lalo, especially for low-lying aircraft, lalo po yung mga helicopters na marotor, it can be a problem. So they are now regulating, but the challenge is really how to monitor kasi there are a lot of drones that are readily available
Correct.
In the market. So talagang, I think dapat po ito, yung operators should be certified, no? Or magkaroon po ng license, ganun po.
There's a need to regulate. Yun lang point.
Okay. That's correct, Your Honor.
Because I filed Senate Bill number 2526 precisely for that purpose. But, so, siguro mas ma-enforce natin ito if there's really legal basis and requirement. Let's make it a requirement. So, thank you for that from the KAAP. And then Secretary, ito, itong Kasi the United States, the Department of Transportation, adopted a policy which will now require airlines to issue automatic refund for canceled or significantly delayed flights. Sa atin ata, we have an administrative order for the Air Passenger Bill of Rights where we recognize the passenger's right to reimbursement. Pero iba yun eh. Iba yun. Parang binigyan mo ng right si passenger, pero passenger, kumilos ka to seek for a refund. Samantalang we can reverse the situation to give the obligation to the airline, to the service provider to automatically refund. Lalo na siguro yung ginamit yung credit card, or there is a way to trace the consumer. So do you need a law to do that, or you can follow that policy na ibalik, i-ano natin yung burden, ibaliktad natin yung, ipasa natin yung burden dun sa nabayaran, dun sa kumita, yung nagkaroon ng cash flow.
Your Honor, Mr. President, according to CAB, since 2012, there's a joint memorandum, yes, between the DOTR and the DTI, yung pong Air Passenger Bill of Rights, Your Honor.
Yes, I mentioned that, pero ang pagkasulat nga ninyo, your record, Section 11, you're recognizing the passenger's right to reimbursement. Kailan siyang kumilos? You have the right eh. So, enforce your right. Kilos ka. Pwede naman natin balik ta rin eh. You will now impose the obligation to the service provider, the airline which canceled the flight or significantly delayed the flight, now has the obligation to refund, to reimburse the passenger. Is that possible without the need for a new law?
Your Honor, Mr. President, according to CAB, that meron pong option, no? It's either to rebook, to refund, or reroute. So it's the option of the passenger, Honor, Mr. President.
Well, may reaction, may immediate reaction dito sa mga naka-experience na, nako, tagal niyan. Kaya nga, so ayaw natin. Are we resisting the idea? We don't like the idea. I just want to know. You don't like the idea na ipasa yung obligation dun sa kabila?
They support the idea, Your Honor, Mr. President. Kaya lang problema daw when the passenger uses the credit card, medyo nahihirapan sila. Yung po sa credit card company doon po nagkakaroon ng problema sa refund. Medyo may complications yung other.
Sila? The airlines will be the ones with the obligation. Pero okay, sige, okay. If you're now entertaining the idea, siguro a quick review. Do we need a law for that or hindi na? You're sufficiently empowered to come up with a memorandum circular to pass the burden, obligation ng airlines to reimburse?
According to CAP, it's sufficient, but they welcome it, no? Because there are many bills right now that are filed in Congress, but it's very, very, very much welcome if it will strengthen.
Ang aking point is, itong administrative action magawa na, gawin na ninyo. I mean, gawin na ninyo kasi maganda yung recognize yung right to reimbursement, pero siyempre kailangan kilusan yung right, di obligation to reimburse ang aking point, the other side of the coin. Tingnan nyo po, pag-aralan nyo na lang po, and tell us if you believe that you need a law, but mukhang hindi na kasi nagawa nyo nga to recognize the right eh. How can you not also recognize the obligation, the other side of the coin? So, okay, so Mr. President, I hope the Secretary has seen that this representation actually wants to help you. I want to help you, and I want to help the entire, hindi lang ito administration, because if we improve the budgeting system, process, maka-discover tayo ng better way to do it. Hindi lang naman ito administration magbe-benefit, even the possible, ayoko na pangalanan kasi itong mga colleagues, our colleagues administration, maybe a Padilla administration, Tulfo administration, hindi natin alam eh. Oh. Okay, so yun yung ating point. We want to help the country. So tignan natin specifically DOTR and then maybe in a anong tawag doon in a parang ano pa yun? As a consequence, even our improving our budgeting process. Kasi maniwala kami sa chairman, ito yung pinaka nakakalito na budget sa lahat eh. Talagang roller coaster siya in reality, okay? GAA level, DEP level, GAB level, committee level, iba-iba. So,
Honorable Mr. President, yes. Tama kayo, parang roller coaster, pero what is ideal? Sana yung release dire-diretso, hindi roller coaster.
May stability. I hope the transportation family, you know, I thank you for your patience, but the effort was really to also help you. Hindi naman para puyatin kayo, but to help you. So thank you for your patience, and then congratulations to our chairman, our sponsor, for
thank
his,
you,
for
our minority leader.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, minority leader.
Thank you, minority leader.
Majority leader.
But Mr. President, before the majority leader asks would put this in the motion to approve, but I would like to thank our colleagues who took part in the interpellation and support the DOTR's proposed budget for 2025. And before we end, I would like to reiterate our appeal to our dear colleagues to include the program appropriations of priority rail projects of the government. We will propose an amendment to include, among others, the PNR South Long Haul project, the Mindanao Railway project, and the MRT Line 4 project. We also hope to work with our dear colleagues in restoring the budget on the loan proceeds of several priority infrastructure projects that were decreased under the General Appropriations Bill. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Majority Leader.